I try to check social media once a day, but I'm like only, so I post and that's it. When I post, I check the previous days. That's like my, what I try to do. That's what I do like 90% of the days, but then I'll have like a 2-week period where it's just like, I'm checking the internet. Like, I mean, it's probably some scary number of times.
And I think a lot of people can resonate with that. I think it's a legitimate addiction. It's like, it's a dopamine addiction. And I don't know if it's a problem, because as long as it's a kind of socializing, like if you're actually engaging with friends and engaging with other people's ideas, I think it can be really useful.
Well, I don't know. So like, for sure, I agree with you, but it's definitely an addiction, because for me, I think it's true for a lot of people. I am very cognizant of the fact I just don't feel that happy. If I look at a day where I've checked social media a lot, like if I just aggregate, I did a self-report, I'm sure I would find that I'm just like literally less happy with my life and myself after I've done that check. When I check it once a day, I'm happy. Because I've seen it. Okay, one way to measure that is when somebody says something not nice to you on the internet, is like when I check it once a day, I'm able to just like I smile, like I virtually, I think about them positively, empathetically, I send them love. I don't ever respond, but I just feel positively about the whole thing. If I check like more than that, it starts eating at me. Like it start, there's an eating thing that happens, like anxiety. It occupies a part of your mind doesn't seem to be healthy. Same with, you put stuff out on YouTube. I think it's important. I think you have a million dimensions that are interesting to you, but one of the interesting ones is the study of education and the psychological aspect of putting stuff up on YouTube. I like now have completely stopped checking statistics of any kind. I've released an episode 100 with my dad, conversation with my dad. He checks, he's probably listening to this, stop. he checks the number of views on his video, on his conversation. So he discovered like a reason, he's new to this whole addiction, and he just checks. And he'll text me or write to me, I just passed Dawkins in the top.
Oh my God. I love that so much.
Yeah. So he's.
Can I tell you a funny story in that effect of like parental use of YouTube? Early on in the channel, my mom would like text me. She's like, the channel has had 990,000 views. The channel has had 991,000 views. I'm like, oh, that's cute. She's going to the little part on the about page where you see the total number of channel views. No, she didn't know about that. She had been going every day through all the videos and then adding them up. And she thought she was like doing me this favor of providing me this like global analytic that otherwise wouldn't be visible.
That's but awesome.
It's just like this addiction where you have some number you want to follow. And then like, yeah, it's funny that your dad had this. I think a lot of people have it.
I think that's probably a beautiful thing for like parents, because they're proud.
Yeah. It's born of love. It's great.
The downside, I feel, one of them, is this is one interesting experience that you probably don't know much about, because comments on your videos are super positive. But people judge the quality of how something went. Like I see that with these conversations, by the comments. Like, and I'm not talking about like, you know, people in their 20s and their 30s. I'm talking about like CEOs of major companies who don't have time. This is their evaluation metric. They're like, ooh, the comments seem to be positive. And that's really concerning to me.
Most important lesson for any content creator to learn is that the commenting public is not representative of the actual public. Yeah. And this is easy to see. Ask yourself, how often do you write comments on YouTube videos? Most people will realize, I never do it. Some people realize they do, but the people who realize they never do it should understand that that's a sign the kind of people who are like you aren't the ones leaving comments. And I think this is important in a number of respects. Like in my case, I think I would think my content was better than it was if I just read comments, because people are super nice. The thing is, the people who are bored by it, are put off by it in some way, are frustrated by it, usually they just go away. They're certainly not going to watch the whole video, much less leave a comment on it. So there's a huge underrepresentation of like negative feedback, like well-intentioned negative feedback, because very few people actively do that. Like, watch the whole thing that they dislike, figure out what they disliked, articulate what they dislike. There's plenty of negative feedback that's not well-intentioned,
yeah,
but for like that golden kind. I think a lot of YouTuber friends I have at least have gone through phases of like anxiety about the nature of comments that stem from basically just this, that it's like people who aren't necessarily representative of who they were going for, or misinterpreted what they were trying to say, or whatever have you, or we're focusing on things like personal appearances as opposed to like substance. And they come away thinking like, oh, that's what everyone thinks, right? That's what everyone's response to this video was. But a lot of the people who had the reaction you wanted them to have, like they probably didn't write it down. So very important to learn. It also translates to realizing that you're not as important as you might think you are, right? Because all of the people commenting are the ones who love you the most and are like really asking you to like create certain things, or like mad that you didn't create like a past thing. I don't know. I have such a problem. Like, I have a very real problem with making promises about a type of content that I'll make and then either not following up on it soon or just like never following up on it.
Yeah. You actually, last time we talked, I think promised to me that you'll have music incorporated into your, like,
I'll share it with you a private link. Okay. But so there's an example of like what I had in mind. I like did a version of it. And I'm like, oh, I think there's a better version of this that might exist one day.
So it's now on the, like the back burner. It's like, it's sitting there.
It was like a live performance at this one thing.
Awesome.
I think next circumstance that I'm like doing another recorded live performance that like fits having that then in a better recording context, maybe I'll make it nice and public.
Maybe a while.
But exactly, right?
Yeah.
The point I was going to make though is like, I know I'm bad about following up on stuff, which is an actual problem. It's born of the fact that I have a sense of what will be like good content and when it won't be. But this can actually be incredibly disheartening because a ton of comments that I see are people who are like, frustrated, usually in a benevolent way, that like I haven't followed through on like X and X, which I get, and I should do that. But what's comforting thought for me is that when there's a topic I haven't promised but I am working on and I'm excited about, it's like the people who would really like this don't know that it's coming and don't know to like comment to that effect.
Yeah.
And like the commenting public that I'm seeing is not representative of like who I think this other project will touch meaningfully.
Yeah, so focus on the future, on the thing you're creating now, just like the art of it. One of the people is really inspiring to me in that regard, because I've really seen it in person, is Joe Rogan. He doesn't read comments, but not just that, he doesn't give a damn. He like legitimate, he's not like clueless about it. He's like, just like the richness and the depth of a smile he has when he just experiences the moment with you, like offline. You can tell he doesn't give a damn about like about anything, about what people think, about whether, if it's on a podcast you talk to him, or whether offline, about just, it's not there. Like what other people think, even like what the rest of the day looks like, is just deeply in the moment. Or like, especially like, is what we're doing going to make for a good Instagram photo or something like that? It doesn't think like that at all. It's, I think for actually quite a lot of people, he's an inspiration in that way. But it was, and in real life, a show that you can be very successful not giving a damn about comments. And it sounds bad not to read comments, because it's like, well, there's a huge number of people who are deeply passionate about what you do, so you're what, ignoring them. But at the same time, the nature of our platforms is such that the cost of listening to all the positive people who are really close to you, who are incredible people, have been, you know, made a great community that you can learn a lot from, the cost of listening to those folks is also the cost of your psychology slowly being degraded by the natural underlying toxicity of the internet.
It's, engage with a handful of people deeply rather than like as many people as you can in a shallow way.
Yeah.
I think that's a good lesson for social media usage.
Platforms in general, yeah.
Like choose just a handful of things to engage with, and engage with it very well in a way that you feel proud of, and don't worry about the rest. Honestly, I think the best social media platform is texting. That's my favorite. That's my go-to social media platform.
Well, yeah, the best social media interactions, like real life, not social media, but social interaction.
Well, yeah, no question there. I think everyone should agree with that.
Which sucks because it's been challenged now with the current situation. And we're trying to figure out what kind of platform can be created that we can do remote communication that still is effective. It's important for education. It's important for just...
That is the question of education right now.
Yeah.